Now we do the heel. One thing I did a little different is I personally need a little more space for my heel. I've got wider feet. So instead of doing the heel exactly like the toe and starting at these end pieces and then doing our decreases and then doing our increases, I actually moved 4 more stitches. So now we are actually using 33 stitches for the heel. So the heel will go from here instead of here to here instead of here. All right, let's get started. I'm going to start the heel over here. I just fold my yarn in half, so I just have a loop. Since it's so thin, you're not going to notice. So I put my loop here. I'm going to be doing my flat stitch. See, there's that end one. There's the 1 and 2 past it. But like I said before, kind of twist this together and flat stitch all the way around to the 2 past this corner one right here. Okay, you can see I went from this peg to this peg. Now we're going to go back and start our decreases. Now we're not going to actually start it. We didn't decrease this one because that's sort of part of the, we'll call it the cast on for the heel. So flat stitch all the way to two before your last. We are on this peg right here, 2 before our last. Now we're going to decrease this one, not that one. This one right here, which it'll have double strands on it just because it was where you cast that on. So you can kind of pull that and you go over to the other end and decrease that one. All right, so I lifted that stitch, put the yarn behind it, I decreased it. Now we are going to work back. You're doing the exact same thing you did for your toe. You're going back instead of decreasing this one. It's already decreased. You're going to go 1 ahead of it. And counting from this one, you'll decrease 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So you'll decrease in 11. We have our decrease done, which I'll go over it. You'll have, this was part of that heel cast one. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 on this side. The part of that cast on one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this one has been decreased. I just haven't knitted past it. So that's number 11. Now we will do our increase. And we will increase 11 on each side. And the increase goes the exact same way. I will go ahead and demonstrate it. You flat stitch all the way to your first stitch, which will be your 10th decrease. Sorry, your 10th decrease on whichever side you're on. So flat stitch to this one. Okay, I flat stitched to this first one that has the 2 stitches on it, which is your 11th decrease. Take both stitches. Now, if one's tight, you might have to pull them over one at a time, but you take both of those over and then you're going to go back the opposite direction. Now, a very common issue with socks is getting holes through your decrease and your heel corner. There are a few different ways you can try to fix this. One thing I found is on your heel, try to use a little tighter tension than you normally do. Not so tight that it's going to break the string, but when you're doing at your decrease and increase parts, kind of like pull the yarn a little tighter and that will help close those up. But you will flat stitch back over to here and you will flat stitch this one and then you'll go back each time, just like your toe. You're picking up one more And do all 11, and all you should have left is one on each side, those cast on ones. Here you go, this is your heel. Once it is done, it's right here. Now, you need to switch your collars. Just cut a few inch tail. We will deal with this and weave this in later. Happens to be on the same side as this, so that actually helps. We are going to add our pink yarn in. Okay, and here's where our yarn was ending. So we're going to start at the same place. Remember, we have one gray stitch left because we didn't decrease those. So you go ahead and knit that one off. And now you go in the round for 10 rows.